Hey guys, it's Jen, and I just kind of wanted to talk to you guys about something that happened to me today. I watch a lot of Criminal Minds, so this really freaked me out. So this morning I went to Walmart to pick up a couple of items that I needed. It's like milk, bread, some iced tea mix. Just regular, you know, just a few items. Anyways, so I got my stuff. I'm in the checkout line, and I usually check out in the garden center because it's less crowded, and it's faster. I don't have to park by all the traffic, you know, whatever. Anyways, so I'm checking out, and this guy, creepy guy, comes up to me and says, like, I wasn't even paying attention. He comes up behind, you know, to the side of me, and he's like, "Hi." And you know, he has, at first, before I looked, I kind of thought that it was like a young girl or something. "Hi, buddy. Joy." Anyways, so I looked, and it was like this creepy looking guy, and I said hi, and kind of just turned back to look at the cashier. There was a couple of people in front of us. Anyways, so he continues to talk to me. You think, you know, oh, you kind of, you know, you just politely say hi to people. That's fine and dandy. But he continued to try and talk to me. And he's like, "Oh, are you ready for the holidays?" And I said, "Yeah." I don't know. You know, maybe the beginning of the conversation wasn't super creepy, but it just creeped me out the way that he was like in my personal space and continued to talk to me when I clearly showed no interest in talking to him. And so he started analyzing the things in my shopping cart. I had Ferrero Rocher, a box of Ferrero Rocher in the front part of the cart. And he's like, "Oh, are you putting up a Christmas tree?" And I said, "No." And continue to look forward. And he's like, "Oh, it looks like ornaments, but it's just chocolate, huh?" I said, "Yeah." And at this point, I'm no longer looking at him. I answer his questions looking straight forward. And then he goes, after a few, you know, moments of silence, I'm thinking, okay, cool, he's got the hint, he's gonna leave me the fuck alone, right? No. So he goes, "Oh, I like your shirt." I said, "Thanks, weirdo." Oh, and this is what, I remembered this too. The entire time he kept like, you know, like you need to go, not a snort, but you know when you do that and you spit, like you like hock a loogie or whatever? Wow, that's pretty embarrassing. I just snorted. But no, he kept on doing that and kept spitting. We're like, I mean, yes, it's the garden center, but you're still inside a store, kind of. And he's spitting. Ugh, it was so disgusting. So, you know, the line starts to move, and I try and move as close as I possibly can to the person ahead of me without really like messing with them and in their space. And he continues to, like, he's like standing, like, you know, diagonally to the side of me as though we were together. Like, if he was so close, we could have been like shopping together. That kind of idea. So again, he continues to analyze things in my cart, and he sees I have a gallon of milk, and he's like, "How much does a gallon of milk cost here?" I don't know, probably the same as it costs everywhere else. And so whatever, by it gets to the point where it's my turn to check out, right? And he starts continuing to like talk about the things in my cart, like, "Oh, that's a lot of iced tea." Cause I bought like a big canister of iced tea mix. And, "Ooh, what's that?" I had some like, what you call it? Flea, you know, the little drops that you put on your dog for the fleas and stuff. He's like, "Ooh, do you have puppies?" I said, "No, I have very large dogs." And I continued to look at the cashier like, what the hell is this guy's problem? You know? And, you know, just the whole thing was really creepy. I watched an episode of Criminal Minds last night where this guy became like obsessive stalker dude to this chick because he, in his mind, envisioned that she was in love with him because she smiled at him on, like, the first occasion that they met, and then he started stalking her. And I was just like, oh my gosh. I just started freaking out. So, finally, I'm about to check out. You know, all my stuff's rung up, and I'm about to check out, and he puts his hand out for me to shake it, and he said, "Hi, I'm Skylar. What's your name?" And I did not respond. I looked at the cashier like, give me my receipt, let me get the fuck out of here. And I took the receipt, and as I'm turning to walk away, maybe I'll see you sometime. No, dude, you won't, ever. And I was really tempted to tell, like, you know how there's a guy who stands at the door? I was really tempted to tell him to stop him. Like, stop that guy, let me get to my car. But I didn't. I just, like, you know, normally I would take my things out of the shopping cart because there was only 3 bags. I didn't really need the bags. I didn't want to waste any time. I kind of just, you know, jetted towards my car. And thankfully, my car was hidden behind a van. And so I just kind of, like, quickly got behind that van, threw my crap in the car, and, like, I was out of there, lickety-split. But, oh, my goodness, that guy freaked me out. Like, seriously. Has that anything like that ever happened to you? And what the hell is wrong with these people? Why don't they get the point? You don't want to, like, talk to them? Wow. Talk about freak.